Zion's Camp, year 2001. Real one.
The purposes of Zion's Camp are many. As we've looked past over the 6 years that we've been doing it, one of the things happens to be pushing boys to the limit, getting them outside their comfort zone. Another is giving them opportunities that they don't get anyplace else. Obviously, there's a spiritual end to it, a chance for them to stretch their testimonies as well as their physical demeanor. And we're grateful that it has seems to have accomplished that for many, many boys. I think the testimonies have built. It's strengthened young men to go on their missions. And it's just given them a great time with great friends to get outside themselves and see others and to serve others and to just get with a group of people that have the same philosophies, the same feelings, the same beliefs, and watch them grow physically, mentally, and spiritually.
Here is the web of life, and what the object is to get their team members from one side to the other side without touching any of the ropes on the web. If they touch the ropes, they have to go back. In life, each of us has a different trial, and that is represented by the different sizes and shapes of the web holes. And so sometimes other people make those choices for us, and we have to go through those holes. And others, we make a choice, and we are committed to going through that particular trial. We have people on this side that will help put people through, and on the other side, people are allowed to help bring other folks through. It can also be an analogy to the life here on Earth and passing through the veil. So we have other people on the other side helping us.
So guys, what you will be doing is putting a blindfold on and having a guide walk you down a trail. And as you go through the trail, the guide will help you go through this by telling you when to duck, when to stand, when to walk, when to stop. So it's important that you follow your guide.
We're doing a trust fall. The boys are falling off of the platform here backwards, and the rest of their cabin is catching them over the top of their cabin counselor as he lays on the ground.
The water balloon usually the goal is Social Kingdom and the target there, and staying consistent and on the mark to reach it in the Celestial Kingdom.
The initiative that we did was called Mission Impossible. The challenge was to get a garbage can outside of a circle that had a diameter of about 50 feet. The trick was they couldn't touch the garbage can with their hands or their arms or their feet or their legs. And they needed to figure out a way to get that can out without touching with those. So they had a couple of things they needed to work on. They needed to decide how many to participate in that. The other thing was that they couldn't speak. Each team had about 3 tries, and they refined as they went, and all of them came up with some pretty good and creative ways of doing it.
This particular game is a timed game. It's called Warped Speed. And the object of the game is to condense the time in which, once they understand the rules, how they can work unified together as a group to be able to pass a tennis ball, a football, and a frisbee, the faster that they can travel these objects to one another. The object is to reduce that speed. The concept is to have them think outside the box. We start them at a large circle, and as they think on how to increase the efficiency and the effectiveness of this game, they realize that going from a large circle in distance, which is the biggest constraint of this game, to reduce that circle, and the circle is the most efficient way to pass these objects, and in fact, passing them all at one time together is the most effective way.
Go!